Hello friends and family, and welcome to my channel. My name is Magnus and this is Green Machine Sweden. A good week ago I attended a tropical fair and bought a lot of new exciting things for my nature hobby. And this is the second video of me preparing the purchases for a long-term solution in my collection of plants and animals. In last video I potted a few orchids and now it's time for some pet isopods. So I'm going to build a pet isopod container. But you may wonder, why keep isopods as pets? I have always kept isopods as a cleanup crew and as food for my geckos. But one day I discovered this little beauty, the Armadillidium maculatum, the zebra roly-poly isopod. And I think they are just wonderful. So that's how it all started for me, and I've been looking at different beautiful isopods, and I have found one that I really liked and looking for it for like 1.5 years or something. And now at the tropical fair I finally found them. What that species is, you have to wait until the end of the video. Now we are building an enclosure for them. I have been through a lot of different enclosures, all with their own benefits and drawbacks, but this is what I came up with is the best for my need. The container is called a Smart Store. It's very rigid and it's smooth surface, easier to put ventilation but also easier to see your isopods. They come with a tight fitted lid which really close it together, and there's no risk for escape. This container is actually a Swedish product, but I have checked, it's available in most of Europe. If you're not in Europe and you're looking for a good enclosure, this is the features you're looking for. A good tight fitting lid, a clear plastic, which is quite solid, and it should be good with any brand really. So like most products, it comes with a sticker, and this one have shown to be very easy to remove without leaving any residues of glue or something, which is really good. So Smart Store Classic 10 is the model I'm using. There are a lot of different sizes, and really it's up to you which one fits best. This one is almost perfect in my cabinet under my terrarium. So I'm gonna mark this up for ventilation. In this case it's another Armadillidium species which needs quite a lot of ventilation, so I will make both sides. That can obviously be done in many different ways. I have come up with a solution that both is efficient and looks really good, and most of all keep the isopods in there. Let's do this. Thank you. make sense to spend a little bit of time cleaning it up, making it look good. After all, they're gonna live in here for a very long time. And yeah, if you're a children watching this, please use a parent for helping with a knife. Yeah, the key is to be careful with the drill. I did make a little bit too much pressure on it, and I did crack one of the holes. It's probably going to irritate me for a long time, but for the isopod, it makes no difference. Anyway, next step is I'm gonna cut up some fine mesh. This is a very fine stainless steel mesh. You can find stuff like this in terrarium related animal stores. I have a special scissor for this, which is very sharp. You should not use your normal scissor for cutting in steel. Also, we're gonna glue it to the box using I use a super strong fix and seal, which is my go-to for gluing on plastic and mixed materials. And after that, I'm gonna take some duct tape and seal it around. It's gonna look beautiful. Let's continue working. Cheers. What I call a very functional and good looking ventilation for an isopod bin. Now I'm just going to let it cure totally, and I will get back to you with setting this enclosure up. See you later. Cheers. So the glue have cured, and meanwhile I have prepared some substrate for the enclosure, so it's now time to set it up. So I use this mix. It's mainly the cocoa soil, and 25-30% is a more coarser one. It's called a cocoa husk, as well as some sphagnum moss. I use the cheap brick version for this one. So it's easy like that, and now we are ready to add the animals. I have them right here. Let's take a look at them before we put them into the enclosure. So here they are. It's Armadillidium gestroi. Armadillidium is, they are called roly-poly because they roll up like an armadillo when they are scared. Just look at this beautiful little creatures. It's like blackish, brown-blackish with lots of yellow dots on them. So I got three boxes of them. There's 10 in each box. That's a total of 30. It makes sense to start with a little bit more individuals in the beginning because all the problems you can get with an isopod culture is really when they are too few. When there are a lot of them, there's not that much issues. So anyway, let's put these beauties into their new home. I will have no problem with using the same substrate. It looks really good, and it looks like it was same kind of product as I use myself. Look at them. There's one on the back like this. They have a little bit of food with them, so I don't need to feed them for this moment. They will most likely go and hide amongst the leaves now. Hey, look at the big one here. What a beauty. Wonderful. So all there is to it now is to just put the lid on, put them in a calm space, and let them get used to their new environment. And I will get back to you in a few days to wrap up this video. So it's been a few days, and let's see how they have settled in their new environment. No one on the cork bark. But yeah, they are running around and being isopods. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to see this culture expand and thrive in the future, and I will make an update. If you want to see that and haven't already, please subscribe to my channel. That's all I have for you today, folks. Thanks a lot for watching. Take care, stay safe. Bye!